And we're back.
That's us.
It's us.
Hey, it's the Juice joined here with the Queen of Bay Area.
Miss Moxie here. Good morning, everyone out there in WFTDA.TV land.
All right. What do we got on the docket for today? It looks like Arizona Roller Derby, Tent City Terrors, taking on the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls from Colorado. And we are in the consolation round, race to fifth place here.
Yep.
So should be a good game. Arizona back in the West Region Tournament after like a five-year absence.
Yeah, it's been a while.
And Rocky, this is the first year in 3 years that they're not going to champs. So playing for pride at this point, playing for positioning, but still some great games here in the second day.
Absolutely. And Rocky Mountain is wearing their dark uniforms today. They are the high seed. And Rocky Mountain seeded fifth coming
fifth
into
coming
this?
Into the tournament.
Yeah,
they're trying
so,
to hold level.
Yeah, it sounds like they'll probably be working on that today. Arizona seeded seventh coming in and were defeated yesterday by the Sacred City Derby Girls, who were seeded 10th. So that number two game yesterday was indeed our first upset of the tournament. And I think so far the only upset. Mm. Everything has been kind of going according to schedule, but something tells me today we're going to shake things up just a little bit.
maybe.
And we're on the big screen. And Juice is scratching his nose. It's
like
breakfast with the Juice. want to give a shout out to everybody watching out there in WFTDA land. You can tweet, you can talk to us at hashtag talk to WFTDA on the Twitter. And let us know what you think about these games, about the strategies, about my hair. And also on WFTDA.com/MVP, you can vote for your MVP of this entire tournament. So make sure to log on to WFTDA.com/MVP and pick your winner. And it sounds like we're getting some intros today, which is something that wasn't really happening yesterday. Maybe we didn't have time.
Announcers need in the fill space. You know how it goes.
Yeah, they just like to hear themselves talk, those announcers.
We'll read a phone book. It don't matter.
And the skaters are taking the track. They are ready to get this thing started. It is exactly 9:59. We're nothing if not on time here at the Bay of Reckoning.
Punctual and slightly functional as we get going. Gee whiz. Already some more roller derby.
Number 924, Loose Chaos, is going to take the star first for the Tent City Terrors.
And going up against Sweet Mary Payne, M80 for Rocky Mountain.
Both jammers out front, but it looks like that's going to be the Tent City Terrors with lead. Not much of a lead, though.
Sweet Mary Payne overtaking her in turn one. So probably looking at a defensive call-off here.
If she knows what's good for her. I see a wall of pink in the back. It looks like the Tent City Terrors are trying to feed Amanda Jamadinha to their jammer, but it's going to be Sweet Mary Payne that hits that pack first. 0-0 for our first jam of the day here.
Yeah, Amanda Jamadinha, tough skater to goat, but excellent effort nonetheless by Arizona.
And I can't quite see her number. I believe that's number 2012, Maria Montoya, jamming for the Tent City Terrors.
Yeah, Maria Montoya having a pretty good game against Sacred City, taking on that veteran squad yesterday. And it looks like the rookie from Rocky, Castrator, going to get through first, lead jammer.
Speaking of having a good day, she had a good day yesterday against Oli. I thought she looked great.
Yeah, a lot of new names coming out of the woodwork for Rocky Mountain in that game yesterday. A lot of the rookies stepping up, Castrator, and Toxic Tonic.
Alpha Q.
Alpha Q doing great work there in that game.
It is not easy to come in as a rookie and jam at this level of play, so
absolutely.
Hats off to those ladies.
And hats off there to Castrator picking up the full five on the pass thanks to some solid defense in the pack from Rocky.
Looks like Maria Montoya, jammer for Tensity, is going to the box on a major track cut. That's not how they want to start this game, I'm guessing.
No, getting in the hole early, down 10-0 to start this one. And Rocky on the power jam, looking for more. Playing some derby pinball at the front. Gets slammed through, 4 or 5 more.
Tensity Terror is trying to form that back wall so that they are the first thing that jammer encounters. And we have a pile up on the straightaway. No whistles, though, so apparently everything that happened there was legal.
The man to jam it in, yeah. Looking in some pain, getting up.
She's got some fancy shorts on today.
Yeah. You get extra points for flair. Oh. And Amanda jamming in you with a nice screen. Running some interference with the front of the pack.
A little and clear to the inside.
And, yeah, this one, fairly easy jam for Castrator with the skater scattered around the track. Going to call it off emphatically.
It looks like she called it off just as the Tensity Terrors jammer was coming out of the box. So we will start this jam with both jammers on the track. That's number 0, Kiki Uraz, jamming for TCT.
And Sweet Mary Payne with the hat again.
Sweet Mary Payne came to you guys by way of Chicago, the outfit, correct?
Chicago outfit, her and number 422, Gagan, on the line there, both from the outfit, making a significant impact on the team this year and helping us make this run in regionals.
Looks like one more jammer penalty, another track cut for the Tent City Terrors jammer. Kiki Uraz is going to sit for a minute.
And that's just unfortunate. Not being able to get going, find the rhythm early in this one, and giving Rocky a chance to build an early lead.
Speaking of early, I'm still drinking coffee. I commend these ladies who are out here at 10 a.m., first game of the day, a lovely day here on the bay. Wow, everything rhymes. But yeah, it's not easy to get up and play derby real early in the morning. It's more of a night sport.
No way. And without delay, it looks like Rocky's jammer sleepwalking her way through the pack again. Sweet Mary Payne with the grand slam.
40-0 here, Rocky Mountain versus Arizona. Arizona trying their best to build that wall and keep Sweet Mary Payne from racking up any more points. She's got some sweet moves, though, that Sweet Mary Payne.
And it is tough when you get isolation on that pack in front. They held her back as long as they could, but just somewhat of an impossible task.
She is strong, too. She's just pushing her way through the pack. She's just got two left to pass.
And blah, 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 swooping in for an enormous hit on the inside. That's going to get her sent to the Hooskow, but some hits are worth it.
It looks like Kiki was sent to the box for a track cut, but it might have just been a minor, so I think she got a little bit confused. She went to the box and then came right back out again. So we do have a Tent City Terrors jammer on the track. No points scored by them. Giant lead here after just the third jam here. 54 points, Rocky Mountain, 0 for the Arizona Tent City Terrors.
And Tent City getting acclimated again to tournament play. Commendably made it back here to the West Region playoff. And just looking to get on the board here to start the consolation round.
I like their stripy helmets and their stripy socks. They look very uniform. We do have a lead jammer here for the Tent City Terrors. I believe that is number 924, Loose Chaos.
Loose Chaos skating with conviction out there. Living up to those white and black stripes.
But she sees a wall of pink in the back there and knows that with the Rocky Mountain Jammer right on her tail, she's not going to be the first one to score. So she chooses to take that 0-0 and call off the jam.
Yeah, still playing it smart, keeping calm. And we're just going to play this game straight. Not worried so much about the scoreboard right now and just trying to get on the board.
All right, 51-50 Lokolina with that pink star.
That's Fiona Grapple, Frida Beater, forming that two wall at the front. Fiona Grapple, last line of defense, one on one at the front of the pack. Lokolina whirling around the wheel. She is your lead jammer.
Tent City Terrors cannot quite hold on to Castrator, however. Oh, well, they did. They sucked her right back in. But
that was a beautiful save there by Messy Missy, number 57, going to the mat for her jammer. That's going to be a penalty for Rocky.
We had no points, 5 points, 4 points.
Yeah, 4 points
scored
on that pass.
We had a no pass, no penalty. She passed the skater out of bounds. And wow, that looked like a clean grand slam there.
Arizona on the rampage now. They got some numbers. They got the power jam, and they are going to town.
They are in this game. No passive offense here. The Tent City Terrors run straight into the wall of Rocky Mountain blockers. That's exciting to watch.
That was a bedazzling skedaddle there to get around that little throng. There she goes, working it inside out. It's a zigzagathon on the track. Gagan forcing her off the Cheerio there.
And it looks like Lokolina hitting the deck one more time. She's going to get back up, though. I think she may have scored all 4 points at this point, but I am not a ref.
Yeah, blah, 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 making the stop there. Oh, gets blindsided.
And Castrator back in the mix.
That was a nice heads-up play by number 56. D's Newts. I think that's how you pronounce it.
I think it's D's Nuts. All right. So we got some points on the board for the Tent City Terrors. 18 picked up in just that one jam.
That was a pretty one.
19.
Make it 19. Give him one more.
Yeah. Maybe another, make it even 20. No.
Yeah,
no.
Come on. Do I hear 20? All right. Looks like single zero, Kiki Yerhaz to the plate, and Uber Alice, number niner.
Number niner.
Getting her first chance to prance.
Yeah, I haven't seen her jam.
Well, you are about to witness something special.
All right. We had an official timeout. I think it's over. That was quick. That's how I like my official timeouts. Quick and painless.
It looks like Messy Misty got a 2-minute penalty. She's going to be in the box for a while.
So maybe once for... I don't even remember what happened. It's too early. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, we have a lead jammer, Uber Alice, for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. Lokolina was just about... Or Kiki Yuraz was just about to get out, and then... AJ happened.
Yeah, so a leisurely stroll through the pack thanks to some phenomenal blocking. And AZRD wanted a cut. They're going to get it. Yeah, splendid defense there by number nine.
Looks like a fourth miner is going to send Uber Alice to the box.
Ginger wreaking havoc. Going to join her there.
We've got a diet pack here. Oh, no. We've got... significant pack advantage, actually. 3-on-2. And now Kiki headed to the box on her fourth minor. So we're going to have a little bit of rotating penalty box jammer time.
Yeah, they're packing them in there like a clown car.
Uber Alice just about takes out her teammate on the way back to the track.
Winona Fighter, the latest casualty to the penalty box. And Uber Alice catching some friendly fire there, trying to just get back on the track. Oh, Amanda Jamadinha opening up the lane. And Uber Alice with a gargantuan jam here.
It may be early, but these girls are hitting like it's 8 o'clock at night.
Hit me with the J in the AM. This is what I'm talking about. I wish we could have started at 6 AM.
AJ, that was like effortless. She just sort of moved her hips a little bit and Kiki Uraz was on the floor.
She has a force field.
She does. I think it's her shorts. I think it's those like, they're like tie-dye American flag leopard print. There's so much going on. It's like making my eyeballs hurt. Yeah, we've got about 18 minutes left to play in this first half. Number 924, Loose Chaos, jamming for the Tent City Terrors, and 378, Toxic Tonic for Rocky Mountain. And the jam has started, but nobody took a knee, and now we have the jammers.
A little bit of stalling off the line there from Assault and Peppa, trying to finagle somebody out of the box.
Lead jammer, AZRD.
Loose Chaos. Spinning around the gyroscope here as she is slamming around the track.
She's got one. I don't know that she is ready for the Rocky Mountain jammer to be coming up so fast.
Dodging traffic. Man, takes a whopping hit for Make You Pay. And that's going to force her to tap out of that jam.
So she picks up 1 point for her efforts, but allowed 3 points to be scored by Rocky Mountain. It's real important to know when to call off that jam when you are the lead jammer. It's all about the differential. It's like 5150 Lokolina jamming for the TCTs. And I can't tell who's on the line. Oh, triple shot Misto for Rocky Mountain. She is through quickly, picks up lead jammer before turn one even.
Skating downhill. She is going strong. And torpedoing her way back around the track. And gets into the thick of it, takes a hit at the far side from a trio of Tent City girls, but picks up the full grand slam.
Arizona looks like they're just kind of getting desperate at this point. They're just sort of trying anything that works. They're staying together, and when they do that, they're successful. But it's when they're going for those big, crazy takeout hits that they're getting sent to the penalty box, and it's not quite working out.
Yeah, it's so tough at this point to try and keep your walls together. But, yeah, when they do have them, they're making some key stops.
In their defense, Rocky Mountain is doing an incredible job of breaking them apart. So
they got the bulldozer going that time. Five more for triple shot Misto.
Bringing us to 86 points for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. 23 for Arizona's Tent City Terrors.
Frida Beater says, throw me on that jammer line.
I like watching Frida jam. She's an incredible skater. I like watching her block, too. And that's Kiki Uraz jamming for the Tent City Terrors.
And again, we got some stalling off the line. There we go, second whistle.
Tent City with a back wall, and that's going to spring their jammer out for lead. Kiki Uraz.
And some fantabulous maneuver in there by Kiki.
Frida Beater out. She is rapidly closing the gap on Kiki Uraz. She's right on top of her. I mean, she got out like half a lap behind and was on top of her so fast.
Frida, the speedster Beater.
She's a powerhouse.
Chasing her down.
Forcing that call off. I spy Loose Chaos jamming again for the Tent City Terrors and Toxic Tonic for Rocky Mountain. I'm having deja vu. I feel like we just did this like two jams ago.
Let's line them up again. Loose Chaos having a marvelous game last game. And it looks like those pants are Scooty Pies.
AJ's wonderful hot pants, courtesy of Scooty Pie, says, talk to WFTDA on Twitter. We are reading your tweets. We can see you. 5 points picked up there by lead jammer for Rocky Mountain, Toxic Tonic. And we had a star pass from the Tent City Terrors. It looks like Sybil War took the star from Loose Chaos somewhere.
And they did it right at the beginning. It was planned before the jam. Wow, Fiona Grapple with the gentle caress there on turn three. Sends her to the basement.
That's a good thing Sybil War is wearing those padded shorts. You hit the deck in those and you don't feel anything. Ooh,
oh, wow.
Sweet moves there. Sybil War in the spin move on the inside, but not lead jammer.
That was some majestic maneuvering, and now she's in her speed skater stance coming around.
The power is held, however, by Toxic Tonic. Sees her about to speed up and score. She says, nope, I'm going to call it off.
And that was Salt and Peppa leading the charge in the pack for Rocky Mountain. She is the founder of 5-on-5 magazine, and we have been remiss to say thank you to them. Check out the official magazine of roller derby at 5on5mag.com. And while we're at it, let's thank some more people.
How about Wicked Skatewear, my buddies. Wicked Skatewear hearts their sponsored leagues, Denver, Bay Area, Arizona, and Angel City. They also heart their dogs, Waffles, and Patrick Swayze. Only Wicked Skatewear would name their dogs Waffles and Patrick Swayze.
Well, voila, Frida Beater makes two passes in no time. And that's a grand slam. Localina playing some jammer defense here. Localina contending with Frida Beater. And Lena able, the first jammer for Tent City, to get him on the board.
Frida trying real hard to get her on the hook and recycle her back into the pack and was successful. However, Frida, looks like a forearm major is going to send her to the box. So, number 5150, Localina, is still trapped in the pack, but it is technically a power jam for the Tent City Terrors if they can get their jammer out.
And Amanda Jamadinha gets tangled up with her, lets her go at about 20. Localina through around the tilt-a-whirl. She is going strong. And Arizona's high scorer trying to put some more on the board here.
Oh. Nice inside clear there by the Tent City Terrors, but it looks like number 37 for
That's
Rocky
blah,
Mountain.
Blah, blah.
Oh, man.
With the body slam. Holy moly.
It looked rough. I am impressed. Localina still standing, picking up a grand slam. That's 5 points the hard way. Juice.
Yeah, she took a shot. Her and blah 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 are going at it, and now she's got a lone blocker assisting her on the track. Rocky with a trio trying to corral her. Yeah.
Frida Beater back on the track just in time to pick up 4 points. Those five, though, will be scored by Localina and the Tent City Terrors. We have a little bit of a score change here. Rocky Mountain at 108 and 33 points for the Tent City Terrors.
And go ahead and give a shout out to PrintCo. Check them out at printcographics.com for your league's printing and promotional needs.
And And it looks like we have Kiki Uraz jamming from the floor there for the Tent City Terrors. However, your lead jammer is going to be Rocky Mountain's Finest.
That's Triple Shot Misto through the pack like hot butter through a skinny pancake. How come butter always gets to be the one getting cut through, you know?
Hit it and quit it there. 4 points picked up by Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. And a little Led Zeppelin. We're getting the lead out here this morning. I don't know if you can hear that, but I can. Number 924, Loose Chaos, jamming for the Tent City Terrors. Sweet Mary Payne, jamming for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls.
And got to give a shout out also to S1 Helmets. S1 Helmets makes the safest and best helmets for roller derby.
You need an S1 helmet in this game with all the people that are on the floor. Man, lead jammer, Sweet Mary Payne.
Sweet Mary playing some Frogger through the pack. Castrator out in front leading the charge.
And Loose Chaos is out of the pack. She has an opportunity to score here, but something tells me that Sweet Mary Payne is not going to let that happen. And I'm right. That's why you guys watch WFTDA.TV, because we know everything.
Called it.
Called it. Saw it happening. I want to give a shout out to Rydell. They are the official skate of the WFTDA. Rydell, unmatched quality, unmatched performance. They also like wheels. The Radar Villain wheel is new from Radar, a sub company, I believe, of Rydell. And I've noticed a lot of skaters out here this weekend wearing Radar wheels. Big crowd favorite here.
And that's rookie Toxic Tonic hacking through the pack, getting some help from Assault and Peppa Gagan to try and secure this grand slam.
Kiki Uraz with just working her butt off to try and get past that wall of black skaters, but it's not happening.
Well, Toxic Tonic going to get sent to the box, deservedly so, for pushing off the head of a Arizona skater to try and get through the pack.
Oh, that's not legal.
Not legal, I'm pretty sure. And that was a Messy Missy, I think, out in front making that stop, stymieing the jammer.
A nice juke there by Kiki Uraz, working to get around and get a grand slam.
Oh, Kiki on the PJ and gets a slingshot from Lokolina. But Gagan there to make the save, along with Frida Beater.
And again, Juice, I think she's picked up that entire grand slam, but she still has not yet gotten out of the pack. Rocky Mountain does not want to let her go.
A Messy Missy and D's Nuts trying to pick up a goat for their jammer, but Rocky just too strong and able to fight off that goat herding effort.
Goat herding. Frida Beater with a little bit of that, like, steamroller backwards awesomeness, just slowing her right down. And we've got one more Tent City Terror going in the box, but being sent back to the track because the inn is full, as they say. Both jammers hitting the deck at the same time. Something's happening there in turn one, Juice. I'm not sure what it is.
A little bit of an oil slick pile of bananas. Not certain. We will find out for you at home.
Somebody threw their banana peel, their breakfast banana peel on the track.
And if you're watching out there on WFTDA TV, thanks for joining us. And thanks also to Bay Area Derby for hosting this tremendous tournament. It's been a fun one.
We have had many league members putting blood, sweat, and tears into this tournament. And we're so excited to have everybody visiting our house. And it's a perfect time of year here in the Bay.
Triple Shot Misto getting centrifugous around the track. I'm not sure if that's a word, but she is the lead jammer, so that's got to count.
Fiona Grapple with a nice hit to the inside on Loose Chaos. She's out of the pack. She is not lead jammer. Wow. Messy Missy with a lovely
Fiona
hit to the outside.
Am Jam going to get sent to the brig on that jam.
Am Jam. I like that she has so many nicknames. I'm going to call her Fancy Butt.
That is quite apt for this morning.
And though it's early, we do have some fans here for this first game here at the Bay of Reckoning Day 2. Some AZRD fans in the straightaway. It looks like Rocky Mountain fans in the turn. It's a battle. It's a battle of the fans.
And here we go. Some more action out there on the Death Donut. Frida Beater towing the line, the stall, some people out of the box.
Loco Lena jamming for Tent City Terrors. We have Diet Pack, just 2-on-2 out there. Loco Lena out first, picking up lead jammer, but Frida Beater gets right back in front of her and says, I know you got that lead jammer nod, but I'm going to hang on to you for a little while, as long as I can anyway.
Yes, ma'am, and Castrator taking advantage of the stellar defense there. And she's going to take the lead.
Looks like Loco Lena is not quite ready to call it. Until now, anyway.
Just a preview. I'm going to wait for Moxie. All right, there we go.
Okay. Moxie said that I'm not going to call it. I'll show her. What does she know? I know everything. I am all-knowing. And I also know that Five Stride Skate Shop is owned by Bonnie Thunders and OMG WTF of the Gotham Girls. They are online, in-store, in the city that never sleeps. That being, of course, New York.
All right, 140, Pushy Tushy. Gonna get her chance to strap on the star.
Sweet Mary Payne jamming for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. She's had a very successful weekend so far as a jammer. She's not gonna stop now. She picks up lead for Rocky Mountain. It looks like Pushy Tushy does get out. Just about a half a lap behind Sweets.
And getting supersonic here around turn three. Both jammers hitting the pack, and that's going to force the call off.
3 points. It looks like Sweet Mary Payne feels like she should have maybe got more than that. She's having a conversation with the referees. Just double checking. I feel like three is pretty accurate. There was one Tent City Terror that she didn't pass yet.
She might have been trying to buy a vowel. I'm not sure.
Oh, yeah. How much do those cost these days?
2 jams.
I ain't got that kind of skrilla. Okay, we have an official timeout. Just in time for us to tell you about Iron Doll Clothing. They have a booth here at the Bay of Reckoning. Run by the beautiful and lovely Iron Maven. Iron Doll Clothing makes custom uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee. They have been lifting and separating since 2009. IronDollClothing.com.
Now these girls have been galloping and walloping this whole first half, down to a minute left, and been a fairly exciting bout to start off our day here on the second day of the West Region playoffs. Rocky Mountain with a huge lead, 123 at Arizona 38, but still pretty fun to watch, I'd say.
Yeah. Juice, you might be able to solve this bit of trivia for me. I see Helen Wheels there, bench coaching for Rocky Mountain. She used to skate for, she may have started the Tucson Roller Derby League. Did she move to Colorado?
Yeah, she's living in Denver now and doing some coaching there for Rocky Mountain.
I see.
Nice little asset anytime you got a Derby legend to come over. Always
she
helps
is great.
Out. It looks like we got a instant replay going.
I love the instant replays. WFTDA.TV, the quality is superb when we're not having those pesky giant tanker ships drive between us and our feed here. We're bouncing off a microwave, apparently, from the city of San Francisco just across the bay, which I can see. It looks beautiful. But every time a tanker ship goes by, apparently the feed gets interrupted. So if you experience Derbis Interruptus this weekend, you can blame it on the tanker ships.
And I'm not sure who was making that hit on the replay, but that was an obliteration. I gotta pay attention to this huge screen in front of me, see if I can catch the next one they pull out for us.
I noticed Gagan sporting a Frida Kahlo eyebrow and, of course, mustache.
And jean shorts. She's a fashion icon.
She is, that Gagan. She says recycle. Gagan, you may not know, came to Rocky Mountain by way of the Chicago Outfit, but she came to the Chicago Outfit by way of the Sacred City Derby Girls.
Aha.
She was once in Burgundy and Gray. She started her derby career there, I think, or maybe started in Chicago, went to Sacred. She's had a long history of friends on other leagues, but...
And she was actually Kevin, her old roommate was Kevin Bacon's cousin, so it comes full circle.
6 degrees of Kevin Bacon's cousin.
That's what we were doing there.
Okay. Looked like we had official review for points there. We had 3-2, but the official call stands at 3. And officially, we have a lead jammer. She's wearing pink. Her number is 5150, and her name is Localina.
And that was some artful dodging there, just lollygagging around the track now. That was quick and in a hurry through the pack for lead jammer Arizona, trying to end this first half on a high note.
And Rocky Mountains jammer getting out of the pack, but it is Localina who's got that scoring position.
Rocky trying to race the pack, but Localina drives on through, hyper warping by the herd.
And for some reason is not calling off the jam. Just in the nick of time, she picks up 5 points and calls it off. So 4 points.
Localina with a couple monstrous jams here for Arizona. And let's see if they call a timeout to get one more in at the half.
They have 3 seconds on the clock. Not sure. No, it looks like that's going to be our halftime.
All right. Going to go in on a good finish there for Arizona. Rocky Mountain with the lead at 123-42.
Welcome to the second half of this game between the Tent City Terrors from Arizona and Rocky Mountain's own RMRG peoples. My name is Miss Moxie.
I'm the juice.
You are the juice.
Word. And so far we have seen some durable and derbyable derby in the first half. Both these teams going at it, so to speak. Been some demolition derby. Rocky Mountain with the big lead, but Arizona doing some pummeling of their own.
Yeah, they look scrappy out there. They're ready for a second half, I can tell. And I want to give a shout out to our buddy Tara Wood, wife of Dave Wood, the photographer. She says, hi, Moxie and Juice. She wishes she was here. She grew up, spent some time in Santa Rosa and San Francisco as an adult. She's talking to us via Twitter, hashtag talk the number 2 WFTDA. So if you want to send some shout outs, we might could say them here. That's the way to talk to us.
Roller Derby is jam-tastic, and WFTDA TV bringing it to you all tournament long.
Live and uninterrupted unless a giant boat goes by.
Indubitably.
Looks like the skaters are just about ready for the second half to start. Not sure about the official, so I'm going to take this moment to talk about roller bones and bones bearings. They are always a winning combination. Check them out at bonesbearings.com.
And it looks like these gladiatorettes are ready to go. They're on the track, but the refs won't let them.
We can't start without the zebras. They tell us what to do.
Wait for it.
Wait for it. There's people at the pivot line, Juice. What's happening? Are we in an alternate reality right now?
I think they're partying like it's 2009.
I do see, yeah. Messy Missy and Civil War, both there up on the pivot line. They're waving to the rest of the pack. Hi, guys. They're saying hello to the pivot line. Aw, they miss it.
The pivot line misses them.
Yes, it's true. That's such a lonely pivot line. So we've got two jammers. May Q Pei, number 99 for Rocky Mountain. And it looks like Loose Chaos, veteran jammer for the Tent City Terrors, is going to be jamming. They're having a little conversation. What do you think it's about, Juice?
Probably lunch.
Yeah?
It's never too early to get started on lunch.
That's true. We've got some pizza here. We've got some tamales here. We've got options. We like our food here in the Bay Area. You know, no burritos, though. I wish there was a burrito truck outside. I love burritos. And you can have one for breakfast. Burritos are appropriate any time of day.
Burritos and derby. That's what BAD stands for, right?
Burritos and derby girls. Yes, that's us. BAD. I wish. We should get sponsored by burritos. We're still having some conference amongst zebras.
I think we're doing two half times.
Oh, okay. Is that it? I mean, the sun is not really interrupting us right now. It does look pretty bright there on the track, but it's nothing close to what it'll be around 6 p.m. today when that sun starts to set. That golden half hour is beautiful here at the Craneway Pavilion. Unfortunately, it does cause some problems when referees are trying to make calls and the sun gets in their eyes. So had to take a little bit of a longer halftime yesterday. All right, we have skaters taking a knee. And the pivot line is no longer occupied. Looks like Arizona thought better of that decision, and they're lining up directly in front of the four wall of Rocky Mountain blockers. Nope, Mr. Rock is still talking. Why does he talk so much, Juice?
I'm not sure.
Do you think he really, like, secretly wants to be an announcer?
Maybe.
Maybe he's, like, just showing what he can do. He's like, look, guys, I can talk as much as you.
They keep stealing our microphones.
They have given him a microphone as the head ref for this bout. He does have the opportunity to use a mic and clarify official reviews. He hasn't had to do it yet, I think, today. But maybe he'll get a chance later. I don't know.
Well, as long as we're waiting, I'm going to thank one more person. Who shall it be? I'm going to pick out Adam Wheels, the proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. And check him out at adamwheels.com.
While we're talking about refs, I want to give a shout out to all of our officials this weekend.
Yeah.
They come from far and wide, and they are doing an incredible job. They volunteer their time. Most of them pay for their own travel to come here and tell us what we're doing wrong. And we couldn't play this game without them. They work just as hard, if not harder, than we do. And we are so thankful for the incredible level of refs that we have here this weekend. And we're off.
Jam-a-lama ding-dong. We are playing roller derby again. And let's make you pay with the hat. Typically a blocker. They're going to throw her in to jam on this one.
Well, with almost a 100-point lead, I feel like they can afford to put out some folks that maybe don't necessarily jam all the time.
Absolutely, and that's a Rad Die, Toxic Tonic, tying up Arizona's jammer.
And AJ with those shorts, driving the boat there in front. It looks like Loose Chaos took a star pass, and she is... No, she thought about making a star pass. I saw her take off the hat, but then she put it back on.
Kind of a little fakery there. She's a sublime skater. That's a probably a good move for her to keep it on. Almost got back to the pack to score some points for Tent City.
So we had a total of 9 points there scored by Make You Pay and Rocky Mountain. Zero there for the Tent City Terrors. They're going to try their luck with Lokolina this go-around. And Sweet Mary Payne is jamming for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls.
Yeah, Lokolina really providing a bright spot here for Tent City in this game. And let's see what she can do to start the second half.
We've got just one blocker on the floor for Arizona and two.
That's Blah 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 and Salt and Peppa slamming her in the waffle iron. The Lokolina getting loose. Thanks to some help there from number nine, Ginger Wreaking Havoc.
Ginger Wreaking Havoc doing her best to hang on to Sweet Mary Payne there at the front, but couldn't quite do it.
Yeah, at this level, it's pretty tough to go one-on-one with any jammer.
Sweet Mary Payne calling off the jam, 0 for Tent City Terrors. And I didn't see fingers in the air for Rocky Mountain, but I'm guessing 4 points. I had to guess. 140 Rocky Mountain, 42 Arizona. So Rocky Mountain just about 100 points ahead of the Tent City Terrors. And Castrator is going to take the star for Rocky Mountain. Number 140, Pushy Tushy jamming for the second time in this bout. But it's going to be Rocky Mountain getting that lead.
And Castrator blowing by the pack of pachyderms in. Going full throttle back through. Picks up a couple, gets the whip from Winona Fighter.
She is hauling. She is almost caught up. Almost caught up to Pushy Tushy. Castrator says, no, I got my 4 points. I'm going to take my ball and go home.
Yeah, four and no more. But that was a pretty one. Here raised the pack in short order.
That officially brings Rocky Mountain 102 points ahead of the Tent City Terrors. So a comfortable lead here, I would say, with 26 minutes and 40 seconds left to play.
Well, Rocky Mountain with a lot of tournament experience and some great rookies with infusing some new life into the team.
Loose Chaos, a quick lead jammer there. She is fearless for the Tent City Terrors.
And she is soaring down the runway here, getting into the scattered crowd. Oh, and trips over.
Looked like her own teammate.
Yeah, that's bad luck there. Hitting the pack so fast, just caught a skate, and now catches a wallop from Amanda Jamadinha.
And she's choosing not to call off this jam. She's trusting her blockers, but it looks like all that effort. 4 and 4, so the point differential stays the same.
Oh, it's triple shot Misto turning on the nitro to get through the last second and match that score.
And you know, you were talking about Rocky Mountain being tournament veterans. This is the first regional tournament that Arizona has seen since 2007, I believe. So, you know, they're the new kids on the block, even though their league has been around a long time. They've got some learning to do. Something tells me they're going to take home a lot of lessons from this tournament, and it looks like they're having a pretty good time out there. So
they are back in action, back in the saddle, and playing with a lot of pizzazz here. And you just got to pay your dues in this sport.
Definitely in the Western region. You got to pay your dues.
This is about the toughest region to come in at the bottom of the pile and start trying to work your way up.
Sure is. Speaking of working your way up, that's Lokolina with a lead jammer nod from Curtis E. Lay, jam ref.
Lokolina pulling off a triple gainer and a sow cow to get through that pack that
Woo!
Time.
All right.
Going to be Frida Beater sent to the pokey. And Make You Pay through the pack, all in one breath.
Lokolina, 4 points. Looks like she's trying to track down Make You Pay and get that fifth, but she says, you know what? I'm not going to let you score. I see you coming up on that pack. I'm going to take my 4 points and be happy with that.
She's like, I'm going to let Pushy Tushy score some points in this next jam. How about that?
That sounds good. And Sweet Mary Payne is wearing a belt to hold up her jorks.
We're ahead of the fashion curve in Rocky Mountain. We're setting some trends.
And we've got an officially timeout. Just in time for me to talk about the OG Shiny Heiny. They may be imitated but never duplicated derby skins. They give you the shiny bum. Check them out at derbyskinswithaz.com. Whoa.
Whoa, jinx.
It sounds like the house ref is also giving a shout out to Derby Skins. That's kind of creepy. I'm not even sitting anywhere near him and he can't hear me. We both have shiny heinies on the brain. Winona Fighter from Rocky Mountain has a shiny heiny today. She's got sparkly chones, but I haven't seen them in a while.
Yeah, out there a couple jams ago with the red sequined, or is it bee sequined? I'm not sure.
But you're a dude. You don't have to know that stuff.
That's like another language.
Oh, look, there's Rock. He's announcing things.
All right.
Saying words. He was just officially clarifying, I think, a no-pack call. He's wearing Antic skates.
No,
OMG.
He's not.
He is. They're pink and white. We talked about Antic earlier, but Mr. Rock, clearly a big fan.
That is a solid wall there from Tent City. Sweet Mary, tough skater to hold back.
They're doing a great job there in front.
Wow, muscling her way to the front of the pack. They did all they could there, but Sweet Mary Payne gonna scoot away with the lead jammer.
She did something super smart that I think more jammers need to do. She turned around and looked as soon as she left the pack to see where that opposing jammer was. Sometimes people just kind of cruise out of the pack willy-nilly and they're not really paying attention. Sweet Mary Payne, not one of those jammers. She's got a head on her shoulder. She knows what's happening. She's very present.
Yeah, definitely picking up the grand slam on that pack and staying patient, taking some heavy artillery from Arizona. Speaking of which, wow, nice hit there from Messy Missy.
One more grand slam. Oh, maybe not grand slam. 4 points. She's contemplating picking up that jammer lap point from Pushy Tushy, but looks like she's just content with burning a little clock time. She does only have 2 blockers on the track, so my guess is she's hoping to burn the clock. And I think
a little bit of an awkward fall there at the end, but it looks like everybody's okay. Castrator back to the plate. That's gonna be I think her first jam of the second half.
And definitely not her first jam. Lose Chaos with that star again for the Tent City Terrors.
Chaos skating off the scale so far in this tournament. And slides out there.
Little jammer on jammer D. Castrator just sent Lose Chaos right into a wall of her own blockers and then proceeded to get lead jammer.
Yeah, that inside lane was wide open and she just, some tightrope walking from a castrator.
That was pretty.
Another 4.
Lightning fast reflexes like a cat. She calls off the jam in the nick of time. And it's going to be 4 points for Rocky Mountain, 0 Arizona, bringing Rocky Mountain's lead to 161 over Arizona's 50 points.
Castrator getting super luminal in that last jam. Toxic Tonic going to try for the encore performance, going skate to skate with Loco Lena.
Purveyors of the Derby Unusual. They're not crazy. They just like Derby. Check them out at derbyology.com. And we've got another Rocky Mountain lead jammer call here.
And Rocky just plundering that pack. Frida Beater and Rad Die there at the front. Oh, another huge hit for Messy Missy.
Frida Beter is incredible with that shoulder. When she's turned around backwards, she can really just sort of guide people. It's pretty awesome to watch.
She is a savvy skater. And Messy Missy in there just cudgeling people. There, that is a hard-hitting bunch. Sybil Ward getting in on the action.
It looks like Rocky Mountain speeding up the pace of the pack. They know their jammer's coming first. They know they have a nice, cushy lead. They're trying to burn some time.
Oh, a nice seal in the inside. Number 56, Deez Nuts, getting it done.
Pile up on turn two. Heard some whistles. 0-0 there.
Hey.
I'm going to have a sip of my sparkling water.
All right. Wonderful. Hey, via Twitter, we just got a shout out at Arizona Roller Derby. Watch party at Little Bo Peep Show's house.
Hi, AZRD at home. Are you guys all wearing pink and stripes? You guys all have your helmets on. You strapped in. You're ready for this game.
I want to cut to the webcam of that party.
I do too. I wonder if they're having mimosas. That sounds delicious.
I just imagine everybody in their pajamas and just partying.
Their stripey pajamas. The Tent City Terror PJs. They could market that. I love these instant replays. Look at that. Woo!
Oh,
that was
man.
That lovely, almost track cut there by Castrator, but she hops, skips, and jumps her way to freedom.
I think she did a cartwheel in there, too. That was Ostrobogulus.
Whoa!
I bought a thesaurus at halftime.
So. I'm going to say, wow. I need to look that one up.
There's a Catholic cruel girl. And Fred Nutz, the coaches for Rocky Mountain and Arizona, respectively.
And having conversations.
They've been in the business for a while. Catholic Cruel Girl, part of that championship. Rocky came in 2010, so she's been around the block, knows her derby.
And Fred Nutz, probably, I would say, some relation to Deez Nuts of the Tent City Terrors.
No relation.
No? I mean, how common is that last name?
That's his name.
Some other folks who have been around the block a few times. Fast Girl Skates, the first full-service brick-and-mortar derby store in the world. They bring their extensive in-store experience to you online. They know firsthand how to make feet happy and skaters fast. You can check them out at fastgirlskates.com. So it looks like this official timeout was to Arizona asked for an official review. They asked for a back block call on the Rocky Mountain Jammer. And according to our officials, the no back block call is going to stand. Hence, Sweet Mary Payne taking the star for Rocky Mountain. And she's going to go up against Maria Montoya for the Tent City Terrors. Haven't seen a whole lot of her jamming in this second half.
Well, I think Loose Chaos and Loco Lena have been getting it going so good that they've been sticking pretty tight with that rotation. But Maria Montoya can definitely throw together a good jam as well.
Oh, we have a foul out. It looks like Deez Nuts has had too many trips to the box. So Deez Nuts is going to go cool her jets. In the locker room, she has fouled out of this game with just about 19 minutes left to play.
And that is a hard loss there for Arizona. That girl's been tomahawking people all over the track and slicing her way through with Sweet Mary Payne out of the whistle. She's got lead jammer.
Make you pay. Taking Maria Montoya to the inside, then the outside, then the inside. She's like, where do you want to go next? I'll take you there. Man, Rocky Mountain, when they get together, when they have their full four on the track, you can't stop them. They play off each other so well. So well. It's like they can read each other's minds.
Very cohesive unit out there. Gagan in the midst of that defense, helping her jam her out with a whip. Sweet Mary Payne going to get through again with some help from Gagan. And that's going to bring the score 179 Rocky, 50 Arizona.
18 minutes left to play. We got a few more jams in this game, I think. One or two, maybe. Did you know Bracket Bonanza is happening on WFTDA.com? You can go to WFTDA.com, fill out your winner's bracket, and if you win, you get a prize, an awesome prize. I can't remember what it is, but I do know that if you fill out brackets for all five of the Big Five tournaments and you are the grand prize winner, you get a trip for two to 2013 championships to be held in a location yet undisclosed, but probably somewhere very exotic and glamorous. So check it out at WFTDA.com and play Bracket Bonanza.
Well, loose chaos getting picked up in the paddy wagon. So triple shot Misto on the lonely jam.
And it looks like Rocky Mountain going to choose to play a little bit of passive offense here. They've got a line in the back, and they're going to let their jammer do all the work. This just in from Double H. It looks like the winner of each tournament's Bracket Bonanza is going to get a DVD set of that tournament and a Jammer Up board game. So if you want to win, you got to play.
Triple shot Misto again, shaking and baking like Ricky Bobby. She is turning on the jets here. Gets an assist from Winona Fighter.
And it looks like Tent City Terrace Jammer has joined the fray yet again. She's out.
Blah, 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 trying to chase her down. Can't get there. Loose chaos. Sizzling her way through.
Blah, 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 also with a mustache.
Oh, triple shot Misto. Turns it around, calls off the jam.
In style.
That was. Hey, we got another Twitter input here at Eric Doak. They're watching in Wyoming, and I called it, they're in their jammies with a bowl of mac and cheese.
Oh, man, I want to join you guys. Mac and cheese and jammies. I could use both of those things right now. You know, if you put a little bit of Frank's Red Hot sauce in your mac and cheese, and believe it or not, Greek yogurt, we like to call that broke mac and cheese. It is magnificent. And the castrator hop, skip, and jumps her way to lead jammer. Not far behind is Loco Lena for the Tent City Terrors, but a hit it and quit it. 4 points there for Rocky Mountain. Will be the end of that jam. Rocky Mountain now with a 152-point lead. 202 Rocky Mountain, 50 for AZRD.
And Castrator just cannonballing her way through again, coming off of that highlight reel replay. She has been putting on an exhibition here in this bout.
Pushy Tushy now seems to be in the regular jammer rotation for the Tent City Terrors. Didn't see her yesterday in their game against Sacred City, but she's out there now.
Well, this is a good game to work your whole bench, get everybody in there, get them all a chance to play here at the tournament. And Pushy Tushy definitely having her moments, but right now Amanda Jamadinha on her like a hornet on a pop can. And Sweet Mary Payne gonna use that to her advantage.
I don't even think that Arizona saw her go through that pack. It was just like in and out.
Oh, Pushy Tushy again with that nice spin move. Rolls around the defender and through the pack. And now swerving around the cylinder, looking for some points for Arizona.
And it looks like calls off the jam. 0 points for Arizona. 2-11 Rocky Mountain. Arizona holding tight at 5-0. I don't know if you know, but experienced derby skaters from Derby for All, they'll get you the right gear to take you to the next level. Mounting plates until Sunday morning at their mega booth here at the Bay of Reckoning. Also check them out at derby4all.com.
All right, triple shot Misto on the track. Looking for the whip from Assault and Peppa. Yes. Going supernova around that turn. She's the lead jammer.
Maria Montoya not far behind.
Maria Montoya playing some good catch up. That is impressive. Triple shot Misto, very fast skater.
She passes her, and Misto says, you know, you can pass me, but I have the power.
And triple shot Misto actually gets called an illegal procedure. I thought she was the lead jammer. She thought so, too. But it was actually Montoya coming through second with the lead, and she's going to call it off for a stalemate.
It's the little things, you know. You gotta be excited when you get that lead jammer nod in a tough game like this. And she looked pretty happy. She's like, you know what? I'll take that 0-0.
Yeah. Played it correctly. And
yep. Played it smart.
Arizona definitely has a lot that they're building on in this tournament, doing a lot of great things, and definitely showing some what do you call it?
Chutzpah,
that's right.
Yeah.
All right, Frida Beater turning it in the high gear, skitters through the scattered crowd, and she is your lead jammer.
Looks like she and Loose Chaos were having a little bit of friendly conversation on the jammer line. Loose Chaos out of the pack, just about a half a lap now behind a scoring Frida Beater and the pack. Rocky Mountain again choosing to speed up the pack. They've got all, well, they did have all four of their blockers on the floor, but it looks like Winona Fighter headed to the box for a, I forget what this one is.
Oh, multiplayer.
Yeah. They're holding hands. Multiplayer block. All right, 11-11 left. Shout out to Tara New 1-1-1-1-1, my derby wife. That's her number. That's all we've got left to play here. 215 Rocky Mountain, 50 points for Arizona. They haven't scored in a while. Something tells me that Lokolina is going to try and change all of that.
Well, Lokolina's been the one to be doing it. And that's the one you want back on the wheel. You get some points to end this thing. Toxic Tonic as well there at the plate.
I wonder if these skaters have had their Derbalife today. Derbalife is roller derby nutrition at its finest. Check them out at derbalife.com. So many .coms, so little time.
Mm-hmm.
All of your interwebs.
.derb.
.derbs. Toxic Tonic out first, quick lead jammer.
Well, that's Overy Z is number 00 leading the charge for a jammer.
Lokolina out of the pack.
Correction, that would be number 60, whoopsie, doing that heavy lifting with the nice blocking at the front of the pack.
And the jam is called 4-0 Rocky Mountain. If I had to guess, Juice, I would say that Rocky Mountain is taking out a little bit of their frustration from their game against Ole yesterday on the Tent City Terrors today.
Well, they're doing their best coming in here. They want to get as high as they can, which would be fifth place at the end of tomorrow. So they're going to play all these teams tough, whoever gets put in front of them.
And the winner of this game is going to go on and play Angel City today at 4 p.m. So with 10 minutes left to play in this game, I'm guessing that's probably going to be Rocky Mountain. And it doesn't look like Pushy Tushy is going to help that. She's going to sit for a minute in the box for a cut track major, making this a power jam for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls.
Yeah, and that'll be a good game later today. Angel City, Sacred City, a good team stuck in a really tough conference. And they got a couple jammers who can really light it up, as well as a pretty solid team. So that should be a fun game later
on today. I am really looking forward to that game, actually. Their Angel City's game against Rose City was surprisingly close yesterday for a 1-8 seed team. I mean, you know, 50 points, not too shabby there for Angel City.
That's just two or three jams. And Sweet Mary Payne buzzing around these worker bees here. Gets another five for Rocky Mountain. Winona Fighter leading the charge. Split pack and easy walkthrough. Yeah, we got tons of great games on tap today. We got Rose versus Ole.
Oh man, at 2 o'clock, Rose versus Ole. So that's gonna be the potentially the winner of that game goes on to the championship bout and will face either Bay Area or Denver tomorrow at 6 p.m. So yeah, the four teams in contention to go to championships in Atlanta, Rose City, Ole, Bay Area, and Denver, one of them will get knocked out.
Yeah, four top-notch teams there. Westerns is not disappointed. Tune in early, tune in often here to the West Region Playoff on WFTDA-TV. And a big thank you also to Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Ride well with Rydell. They got to pay me for coming up with that tagline.
And you know, if you want to talk directly to thousands of Derby fans, you too can advertise on WFTDA.TV. They have affordable packages available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor opportunities to learn more.
That was Sweet Mary Payne featured in that last replay highlight. Doing some fancy footwork. Oh, what
it looks like
that?
The Tent City Terrors are sharing a moment there. Their blockers on the track are comforting each other. And they're just going to hang out there and see what this power jam has in store for them. If it is indeed a power jam, I only see Loose Chaos out there. I don't see a Rocky Mountain jammer.
Could very well be a power jam. It looks like Ginger Rican Havoc just got sent out on penalties. That'd be number 9 for Arizona.
So we have two foul outs for the Tent City Terrors. They are not, they're not playing easy today. They are leaving everything on the track, as they say. And that is the way that you want to play in this kind of tournament. You give it everything that you have, you go out with a bang.
Yeah, if you're not getting penalties, you're not trying hard enough.
If you're not on the ground, you're not trying hard enough.
That's what Coach Juice says.
We still have a bit of an official timeout. Blood and Thunder Magazine is the world's first and largest roller derby magazine. You can find them at bloodandthundermag.com.
Well, we got 7 minutes left in this scuffle.
It looked like Mr. Rock was clarifying something that I couldn't quite hear, unfortunately. He's just clarifying that foul out by number 9.
Yep. Way ahead of you.
See, we know everything.
Yeah, come on, refs. You should have just asked us. We could have told you that.
That was so 3 minutes ago.
Oh, man. Rocky Mountain, ferocious on that outside line.
And Loose Chaos coming out like a fire is lit under her butt, picking up lead jammer. It is a power jam for the Tent City Terrors.
You got to go through Pakistan to get to lead jammer land, and she did it that time. And some resets.
That was amazing.
Yes.
Nice footwork there by Loose Chaos.
Just whirling around the wheel. Loose Chaos showing what she's got.
And it looks like multiplayer block. Gonna send AJ to the box. One more grand slam for Loose Chaos and the Tent City Terrors. Their fans on the straightaway having a good time with this power jam.
Yeah, Rocky Mountain's blockade, no match for Loose Chaos's schlager in there. And she has taken over this jam, a grand slam.
She's grimacing a little bit as she comes around turn 4. I would be too if I went through the meat grinder that is the Rocky Mountain Pack.
This is a scorching jam there for Loose Chaos.
She
courageous
up,
effort. Wow.
Yeah, 14 points total, but Sweet Mary Payne with four of her own, I think, just snuck up on Loose Chaos there as she came out of the box.
And Arizona's bench is pumped. High fives all around, and they should be trying to end this thing in the right way. There you see her working on that inside line. That is some tightrope walking from Loose Chaos.
Keeping it clean, keeping it casual. 69 points, AZRD, Tent City Terrors, 255 Rocky Mountain, and we have a lead jammer. Who is that, Juice?
That'd be Triple Shot Misto. Didn't even hear her go through. She put the bell in her mouth and creeped on through the pack. You know, like how cats do sometimes?
Oh, I don't have a cat. I've got a dog, and he is anything but quiet.
Triple Shot going to work here against Civil War, 43 at the front of the pack. And can't stop her one-on-one. She takes a peek, sees Localina on a furious charge, and decidedly calls off the jam.
Yep, just under 5 minutes left to play. 259 Rocky Mountain, 69 Arizona. And last but not least, left turn training. That's coaching by Mercy, Scald Eagle, and Jukebox that'll help make your skaters more awesome than they already think they are.
And last and definitely least, I'm the Juice, and we're going to watch more roller derby.
Yep. I'm going to be Miss Moxie for the rest of the day. I don't know what I'll be tomorrow, but I'll be Miss Moxie today. And Maria Montoya taking the star again. Lead jammer for the Tent City Terrors.
And she is just plummeting through the pack. Drills her way through. And wow, here comes the speedster Frida. Beat her, trying to get her.
So fast.
Wow.
And Frida forces that call off. Goose egg on that jam.
She really got on her sleigh there. And sometimes if you want to get through the pack, just tie a rope around Frida Beater.
Sounds like a good plan. Is Frida a personal trainer, or does she just work out a lot?
She's a cop.
She's a cop. Okay, so she's just naturally in amazing shape.
Yeah.
Toxic Tonic taking the star for Rocky Mountain. Pushy Tushy one more time for the Tent City Terrors. And they're scrumming it.
Yeah, I think the jammers just got eaten by the pack. Oh, Toxic Tonic getting scrumptious around the circumference. Emerges somehow for that lead jammer.
Somehow, majestically.
Pushy Tushy again with that slow roll around a defender. That has worked well for her today, but picks up a penalty on that one.
You know, it looks like Gagan forced a major track cut on Pushy Tushy there in turn two. Incredible blocking by the Rocky Mountain Pack. We have a question on Twitter about foul outs. There were two foul outs in this game, but they won't be reflected on Ringster until the official stats are validated for the game. So that's why you're not seeing them yet on Ringster. But yes, two folks from the Tent City Terrors have fouled out of this game for too many trips to the box. You can go six times, but once you go seven, you're out of there.
Well, Toxic Tonic jiggling and jaggling by again. A lot of contact on that first turn, but no penalties called for either side. So letting them get pretty physical here at the end of this one. Oh, wow. Toxic Tonic pulling that Pushy Tushy move and winding her way around that last defender.
She looked happy to come in at the back of the pack. She's smiling. She's enjoying herself.
Well, Ovary Z and Whoopsie did a phenomenal job holding her back. But she had to cut the track to get through, so we're going to see Arizona's jammer come on back.
Just about a minute and 40 seconds left to play. She's out. But as she came out of the penalty box, she will not be your lead jammer. Also because Rocky Mountain's jammer held that.
And saved by the bell there at that one. A minute 30 left
And we're going to start this as a power jam for the Tent City Terrors. Jeez, I kind of doubt they're going to make up the 200 and some odd point deficit right here, but at least they're going to try.
And there's that move again from Pasha Konic.
Wow.
Faces up, turns the corner, almost makes it, but then gets snagged by number 5, Bookham Betty, with the excellent save there on the turn.
It looks like the girl they're going to pick to put the star on is number 5150, Lokolina. She's going to jam for the Tent City Terrors.
And that's who you want on the power jam, ending this one strong. It's been an all-out slugfest, and let Lokolina have one more roll at this.
Don't forget to stick around after this. We have Rat City versus Wasatch Roller Derby. I can see the stands starting to fill with blue. Wasatch comes all the way from Salt Lake City, Utah, and they brought a crew. They have a gang here, and it was loud during their game with Sacred City, who did they play yesterday? Angel City.
Yeah.
Yesterday.
They brought it.
Their fans are hilarious. They had these giant signs I guess they were signs, but they were pictures of each of the girls' faces that are like 5 times the size of an actual person's head. So like the stands was filled with giant heads on sticks. It was sort of creepy and amazing all at the same time. And Lokolina, it looks like, is trying to get her fans riled up.
Getting the wave going.
Yeah, getting them to do the wave. We've done the wave here at the Craneway Pavilion.
Yeah.
Maybe we can get it going tonight when people are a little more awake.
We get things getting bodacious in here at the Craneway.
Bodaciousnosity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, one more shout out, one more thanks to Adam Wheels, big old longtime sponsor of WFTDA. Check out adamwheels.com.
All right, it looks like we're just about ready here for what could potentially be the last jam of the game. We've got a minute and 13 left on the clock.
There's the whistles. Lokolina on the oval to end this one. Perhaps.
Stick around right after the end of this game. Brad Example is going to chat with a Rocky Mountain skater after this game.
Oh, and kind of lost her foot in there.
She says, I'm going to try that again.
She saw that tidal wave of Rocky Mountain awaiting her.
Once again, Arizona choosing not to play passive offense. They are actively blocking for their jammer.
Fiona Grapple with the jammer takeout. And they're trying to bridge, but too much space. Lokolina going to get through for the lead jammer.
Do we have a flamingo on the track? No, that's just a Tent City Terror with her foot in her hand. Looks like she was adjusting her toe stop. Mid jam. All right, we've got a power jam there for Lokolina and the Tent City Terrors.
Yep, Arizona ending this one in style. Picking up the nickel there. Oh, my goodness.
Toxic Tonic coming out of the box and Lokolina saying, I want to put you on the floor one more time before this game is over. Can I do it?
That was
yes,
an uppercut there on turn 4. Maybe the hit of the game coming in the last jam.
I hope we get a replay of that.
That's as jammerlicious as it gets.
All right. And Lokolina calling off the jam, picking up 2 more points for her efforts. We have a minute until we get a final score. But a hard-fought bout here by the Tent City Terrors. Rocky Mountain with about a 200-point lead. And maybe these guys are going to go have lunch together. They're definitely going to high-five.
Well, their league's been playing from the first Dust Devil, so they know each other well. They've been through a lot, ups and downs. I think Arizona won the very first meeting between these two teams way back in the day.
Yeah, They were a force to be reckoned with at the first Dust Devil in 2006.
Yeah.
And they're just getting their sea legs back. I'm guessing we'll see them again.
We'll be seeing more of them. They always come to Rumble, and it's always a great time seeing Arizona Tent City Terrors play. And here comes the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls 5280 Fight Club.
Taking their victory lap.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Brad Example for WFTDA.TV here with Fiona Grapple, number 31, from the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls 5280 Fight Club. So Fiona, just now you beat the Arizona Roller Derby Tent City Terrors by over 200 points. How did it feel out on the track?
Good. They're a really physical team. That score doesn't necessarily reflect how it felt playing them. They did a lot of really good things, but it felt good. You know, our team's working on cohesiveness and communication and holding our walls tight. And I think this was a really good game that gave us an opportunity to kind of fine tune those things that we need to work on for bouts later on this weekend.
Excellent. Your next opponent this afternoon is going to be the Angel City Derby Girls. You've had a chance to see them skate a couple times already this weekend. What are you going to be looking for from them?
They are a really big physical team. So we are going to need to make sure that we are keeping very tight walls, that we're not letting them push us out of play. I think it's going to be important that, you know, we play some good offense and just contain their jammers.
All right. Well, the 5280 Fight Club has a lot of fresh faces on it this year, quite a few new folks from last year. How are things working out for the new look 5280 Fight Club?
You know, I think it's great. This has been a rebuilding year for us, and I'm really, really pleased with how well we've come together. We've got players, you know, Castrator is a really good example. This is a skater who at the beginning wasn't even on our B travel team at the beginning of the season, and now she's one of our starting jammers.
Yes.
So I'm really impressed with our team this season.
All right, well, good luck later today.
Thanks.
And good luck with the rest of the tournament.
Right,
so with Fiona Grapple from the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls, this is Brad Example for WFTDA.TV.